You don't have to be huge like Rafa to be able to hit a really powerful one-handed backhand. Suarez Navarro is a perfect example. You're gonna see her set up points with her one-handed backhand, keep the ball deep in the court, change direction with her backhand, dictate points with her backhand, and hit winners with her one-handed backhand. And she's smaller than I am at 5'4". So you don't have to be huge and strong. Yes, she is strong, she's an athlete, but is she 6 foot tall and just, you know, huge muscles like Rafa? No, she's not. And so if you want to be able to win points, dictate points with your one-handed backhand, it's all about leveraging your body. And understanding how to do that correctly is the key to really accessing all of that power on your one-handed backhand. Kevin's gonna go right into the three elements that are so critical for getting all of that leverage and creating more power right now.
So you wanna crush your one-handed backhand? Learning the leverage positions is the key to doing that. And so by learning the three major leverage positions, allow you to swing with effortless power. So let's get right into it. So with Raja, the first thing we're gonna talk about, the first point of leverage is the unit turn. And the keys to why the unit turn is so important, because it sets up everything else. It allows him to have really smooth and easy timing. I mean, when you look at a lot of one-handers, they seem like it's effortless, and the unit turn is the first piece of that puzzle to make that happen. And so exactly what the unit turn is where Raja's turning his outside foot here, but really he's focusing on turning his shoulders. And what's really key as he's turning his shoulders is he hasn't moved the racket back. His arm hasn't went back by itself. It's really by turning the shoulder sideways, it's starting to set it up. And then from here, the arm does go back into the full unit turn position. Really key, he has separation between his hips and his shoulders. Look how far his shoulder is kind of tucked under his chin, and his hips are facing one direction as his chest is facing back at the second direction. So the second key is the slot position. So by having great preparation, it sets him now up to drop the racket into the slot position. And the reason why the slot position is so important is because it leverages your racket like a hammer. Just like you think about when you hold a hammer and you pull it down, the handle pulls the head into the handle pulls the head into the nail and accelerates it down. Well, the same thing is happening, but it's happening around his body. So as Roger drops the head, and this is the slot position, he's gonna pull it forward. And you can really see how he's in this position, the butt of the racket's facing to the side, he's really set his body up to pull forward, and the racket is slightly under the hand. This is the key to having the slot position here. Now, this leads us into our third and final leverage position, which is how he uses his body. You can really tell that Roger's turning his body, which generates and magnifies these other positions, like the slot position. By itself, yes, you can produce a lot of power, but when you add your body rotation, it just turns up the knob on the amount of acceleration you can achieve with minimal effort, and that's how you're gonna learn how to crush your one-handed backhand. So if we watch here, really watch the Nike sign on Roger Schwartz, and watch how, as he turns his hips, he's not gonna drop the racket in the slot position, and then pull, and then release the hand through the ball. Now, the rotation of the body is half rotated compared to a two-handed backhand who completely rotates the hips through the ball. The one-handed backhand just needs that initial start, and then it sends the energy through the arm and down to the racket, as you can see here, to the follow-through. And again, if we go over all of it again, we have the unit turn here, the slot position, the pull, and then the finish. And those are the three positions you need to learn to crush your one-handed backhand.
Now that you've seen a world-class example of what professional level technique looks like from Kevin showing you Roger Federer, let's look at some other real life examples of real life players just like you, amateur athletes, that have made amazing transformations in those same three key positions. Let's go right to the court here. And this is a recent student of ours named Rick. And we focused on the coil position with Rick, the unit turn, the setup position. The reason why we focused on it is look at where his hips are facing, right about even with the camera, and look at where his shoulders are facing, also right about even with the camera. So this is his before example. This was the load position that he started with. After spending some time with Rick on the court, working on that coil position, watch the position he gets into now to set up for his backhand. Now his hips are still facing the camera, but look at his shoulders. Now his chest is pointed back towards the back corner of the quirts. And so from here, he's in a much stronger position to use his body to hit the ball and uncoil into the shot instead of relying so much on his arm, which is what was happening before. Moving on from the uniturn, we'll shift forwards into the slot position or the butt pole position. This student's name is Miguel, and he was struggling with his slot position. He does pretty well preparing his body, but watch his racket face as he moves forwards towards contact. He never gets down into that nice, strong, leveraged position that Kevin was talking about and showing you with Federer. Instead, his racket face stays super shallow, and it doesn't really make its way around his body very well, which means that he's not in a leveraged position, and he has to really, again, rely on his arm and his hand to hit the ball instead of using the leverage of his shoulder and his forearm to release through the point of contact. Here's Miguel again after working on that slot position. Watch how as he prepares his body, now his racket actually drops back behind him. And it's not perfect yet, but this is a massive improvement from where he started. He's no longer just kind of pushing his arm forwards. Now you can see how there's a leveraged position where he can use his shoulder, and his whole body is just much more balanced and much more able to use the big, stronger parts of his body to hit the ball easily, but still with good power. The third technical element that Kevin focused on was the leading of the hips forwards, initiating the forward swing of the racket. And if you look at this student, he had kind of a unique flaw in his backhand swing in that as he started swinging forwards, his back knee and his back foot actually pivoted and turned away from contact. And so you can clearly see how that makes it impossible for his hips to actually release and turn forwards. You can see how he's kind of fighting against his own lower half of his body. And that just makes it absolutely difficult to make any kind of smooth use of the kinetic chain forwards. And now here's a clip after a little bit of work with this student. Watch how now his hips are actually actively turning forwards towards contact. And it's because this back foot is now pivoting in the correct direction. That back knee and that back foot are both rotating towards contact, and that frees up the hips to be able to actually move forwards and initiate the forward rotation of the body and the forward rotation of the racket in the contact. So these are some awesome before and after contrasts. We want to make sure you can do this too. That's why in the very next video that we publish, we're going to show you step by step the drills that we used with these players to achieve these results. And best of all, we'll also show you how you can use the same types of drills by yourself to train your own one-handed backhand, to make it stronger, to help you create easy power very, very efficiently. So we're going to link to that video right now. You'll see it, and you can click on that video and go ahead and check out the drills and do them for yourself.